Well, as with the state Kate Steinle case, it looks like a young American might still be alive if the country were simply willing to enforce its own federal laws. Luis Miranda is a former DNC communications director, and he joins us tonight. Luis, thanks a lot for coming on.
Thanks, Tucker. It's good to be on.
So the line that the rest of us are kind of forced to accept is that all immigrants are great people, better than us, in fact, and that if we suspect otherwise, we're bad people. If we point to evidence proving otherwise, then we're flat out bigots and we should be quiet. Why don't Americans have a right to police their own borders and say, if you're not here legally, you have to leave now? Why don't we have that right?
Well, Tucker, I'm really glad that you're giving us the opportunity to have this discussion, because I think Democrats, Republicans, independents, immigrants, and those born here all alike, we can agree that these heinous crimes have no place regardless of who does them. You know, just this week, we found out that a white man in Denver killed his wife and two beautiful young daughters. Also tragic, just as this young woman in Iowa whose death is a huge tragedy, and I can't imagine what her family's going through. So we can agree on that.
But here's the difference. But, I understand.
But there's a white man in Denver who doesn't speak for all white men either.
Hey, Luis, I didn't say anything about this man's race. This story is not about race. Don't make it about race. Stop that. I was saying this is about nationality and citizenship. This man had no right to be here. That's the difference. Lots of Americans commit heinous crimes. It's terrible. We put them in prison where they should be.
Exactly.
But people shouldn't be here in the first place. He didn't have a right to be here in the first place. He should not have been here. His presence violated federal law. You and your party tell us that we're racists for wanting to enforce our own laws. It has nothing to do with race. It has everything to do with whether we think laws are real. And some of us do. You don't.
There's more we agree on. We both agree that the immigration system is badly broken. It is horribly broken. And the people who stood in the way of fixing that have been oftentimes Republicans. And I'll give you an example of what worries me about this case.
No, you don't. This is just spin. It's really simple. I ask you a question, please answer it. Why don't we, as American citizens, you, me, our neighbors, everyone, a citizen, immigrant or not, but who is an American, have a right to say, if you don't have a right to be here, you must leave? When did we lose that right? Why don't we have that right?
And I'll tell you when. When people who own big corporations, companies, who are inviting these people to come work, oftentimes at depressed wages, because they need the labor. Look, George W. Bush.
I agree with you completely.
I agree with you completely. Wage laws and brought Mexican immigrants to help with recovery and reconstruction after Katrina.
To his eternal shame, and the unemployment rate among
to draw them.
No, oh no, you're absolutely right. But what you're missing is the African American unemployment rate in New Orleans remains very high. Those jobs went to foreigners. They didn't help the Americans who need the help in New Orleans. And I can give you
$1,000.
You're right. I agree. To his eternal shame. It's one of the reasons he has a lot to be ashamed of from his 8 years as president. That's one of the main things to be ashamed of. But I have still a simple question. You and I agree on that. So why don't we say to employers, you must verify the legal status of your employees, and if you can't, you can't employ them. And if someone's got a fake ID, that's a felony.
One of the things we tried to do under the Obama administration was to expand e-verify. No, actually, that was part of the immigration bill that we put forward in 2013. Yes, it was. It was. Absolutely. It was something that we
always included. Because Democrats are totally against it now. Totally. Because they take money from these employers that rely on the cheap labor you just mentioned.
The Gang of Eight included it, and it included border security.
That's not true.
It included verification. Absolutely. Absolutely. That's always been
part of what we tried to do. Why right now? But it's not true. Democrats right now ask members of the Senate, the 40-odd Democrats in the Senate, are you for universally e-verify? If you can't prove that your employees are legally in this country, you can't employ them. Are they for that? You can't get a majority
during the Obama administration,
right now, you know
we set off drones
It's 2018.
To fly from Texas to California. We added border patrol agents. We agree that we need a safe and orderly border.
It didn't work.
What the disagreement here is how do you use your resources? And the problem that I have right now is that we have immigration agents chasing down moms taking their kids to school instead of looking for real criminals.
It's just
like the
silly.
One that
it's just
you
silly. Here was,
at the beginning of this,
here was a real criminal. And if we eliminate ICE, as Democrats are calling for, then how do we police our immigration laws? We can't. You literally represent a party that would like to eliminate immigration enforcement.
What I think is important is that as long as Trump and other Republicans keep politicizing immigration enforcement, it turns into this kind of debate that takes away from the reality that we need a safe and secure border. We need someone who is actually stopping the flow of illegal guns and drugs north and bulk cash south. We did that during the Obama administration.
I'm sorry. This is disingenuous.
So we're both in agreement in that.
The country's flooded with heroin from Mexico.
We are both in agreement in that.
Yeah, okay.
We are both in agreement on that.
That's not true.
But when you politicize it and you force law enforcement agents to go chase a mom going to school, taking her kids there, and raiding factories.
I appreciate it. Right, okay.